L-arginine is an amino acid that not only helps your body produce proteins, it also releases nitric oxide into the blood, which has been seen to widen blood vessels in the bloodstream, which is why it's used in hair loss, erectile dysfunction, and other conditions where a wider blood vessel is needed. And while many of us get our L-arginine from our diets, for example, in lentils, turkey breast, red meat, and pumpkin seeds, sometimes the need for L-arginine may be more than the body's ability to produce or get it into the diet naturally, which is why the question on supplementing comes up in this video instead of going into all of the benefits of L-arginine for hair, erectile dysfunction, fertility, libido, sleep, and blood pressure, which I can make a separate video about. All you have to do is let me know in the comments. Instead of all that, I'm going to turn our attention to how L-arginine works exactly, the safety of L-arginine in terms of how much is safe to take, and the side effects that you need to know of so that you can become an informed consumer about L-arginine products. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions, as well as being the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for y'all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider subscribing as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's take a look at how L-arginine works exactly. L-arginine is an amino acid, and amino acids are building blocks for proteins, but it's not your typical amino acid. It's actually a substrate for the enzyme endothelial nitric oxide synthase, which is found inside vascular endothelial cells and is responsible for the production of nitric oxide, which we know causes vascular smooth muscle cell relaxation. In other words, it widens your blood vessels. And when you widen your blood vessels, you increase the supply of blood to whatever area you're trying to get blood and nutrients to. But that's not the only thing nitric oxide does. It is also important for mitochondrial function, as well as the way for cells to talk to each other. And you got two types of L-arginine, right? You got your IV form, brand name Arginine 10, and your capsules and tablets. And while we're on the types of L-arginine, let's not forget to mention the dosing. There are quite a bit of different ranges for this one. This is why it's frustrating. But the average dosage of L-arginine is anywhere from 6 grams to a maximum of 30 grams per day, which can be divided into 3 times a day, but not to exceed the 30 grams. The study here highlighted that to minimize the risks of side effects based on physiological and biochemical variables, study subjects tolerated oral administration of 15 and 30 grams of arginine in a day without adverse events. So anything over that and the risk of side effects does go up. You might be thinking, what can be so bad with taking more L-arginine? It's an amino acid, it builds proteins. Isn't it better? Here's what you gotta know. Because L-arginine opens up blood vessels, taking more than 30 grams a day may cause dizziness, fainting, and low blood pressure. And this is especially true if you're already taking medications that already lower your blood pressure, like your ACE inhibitors like lisinopril, beta blockers like propranolol, calcium channel blockers like amlodipine. The combined effects may be just too strong here. Other common side effects are bloating, nausea, and vomiting. And a lot of the times what people do is combine it with L-citrulline, because we have studies that show us that L-citrulline dose dependently and more effectively increases plasma L-arginine levels than L-arginine by itself, which is why cyclists love it so much, since it can help with their cycling times. In fact, a reduction in completion time of 1.5%, as the study mentioned, it can be a big deal to some. A good combo, if you're wanting both, is 500 milligrams of L-arginine with 250 milligrams of L-citrulline, a supplement that is third-party tested, of course, and made in a GMP-compliant factory. The one by Nutricost fits that criteria, and I've left my affiliate link for it down below in case you wanted to check it out. And of course, for erectile dysfunction, the dose there is slightly higher. 2.5 to 5 grams of L-arginine would be better in this situation. As for L-citrulline for erectile dysfunction, the single-blind study looked at a dose of 1.5 grams per day that was safe and well accepted by the volunteers. And I'm sure I'm gonna get asked, how long will it take to work? Well, it takes a minimum of 24 hours for the L-arginine to absorb into your body, and maybe best absorbed between meals, just FYI. And in some cases, to see the full benefits of regular L-arginine treatment, depending on what you're trying to treat, know that it could take up to 3 months. But of course, this will vary person to person, so it really is hard to measure the exact timing. Now, lastly, before I forget, let's talk about who it's not for. You want to avoid it if you recently had a heart attack, have cirrhosis of the liver, have a guanidino acetate methyl transferase deficiency, which is a disorder that affects arginine metabolism. And lastly, it's best to consult with your doctor first if you're under 16, over 65, or pregnant or breastfeeding. Share with me your thoughts down below though. I'd love to hear it from you. Also, the video right here looks at L-theanine and the video here looks at L-carnitine in case you want to learn more about them. Click the subscribe button down below if you found any value, guys, and I'll see you on the next one.